What's up? You gonna cut it or?
No, keep going.
Yeah. You know, I just cut it. I gotta cut it. Okay. We back Talk Your Shit podcast with my guy. You already know what it is.
What the fuck?
Hold on. You didn't say something. You didn't say shit. You didn't like
that. Right.
No, you said, wait, I said that.
No, you gotta say your whole Instagram.
So what I gotta say? Just get it.
Slim baby, I see you. Listen, hey. The streets make the hustlers. Hustlers make the world go round. The world is made of keys, ounces, and pounds. The keys, ounces, and pounds is made from hustlers. See how shit come back round for you. Gotta cop it, chop it, and cook it. See how shit come back round for you. Got a kick in the oven, I watch it bubble. And you can knock on my door, but you can't knock the hustle. But it's like a game of 21, and I got 19 in my jig. But I
put Gambino back, Talk Your Shit podcast.
Big Tweezy two times, man. Welcome back. We here once again. Next episode. Episode 6.
Yeah, I think that's 6.
Yeah, so first thing popping this week is motherfucking YW Melly. Got a mistrial. I feel like that's fucked up, or like, how you feel about that?
Man, that's crazy, man. I ain't even gonna lie. I feel like...
Hold on. Listen. Can you explain what a mistrial is to the motherfuckers that don't understand what it is?
I'm gonna keep it real. A mistrial is real shit like... Man, I don't know fucking know what the fuck a mistrial is.
All the jurors ain't vote the same. Red is guilty or not guilty.
Real shit.
So now he got to go through trial again.
Real shit.
You don't get to go home. You don't get to do nothing.
No.
It's basically like...
It's remix. Like, we bringing the shit back.
It's not a joyous point. Like, you can be happy.
It's not a sad
point. You should be sad because... Yeah.
We basically ready to bring a brand new motherfucking team in for you. You know what I mean? You know our team got 5 motherfucking starters and 7 niggas on the bench? Right. Yeah, we ready about to bring 5 motherfuckers, another 12 in for your ass. You know what I mean?
So that's what we about to do. And this is what murdered y'all, so your life on the line.
Real shit. And hopefully it ain't the Vancouver Grizzlies. Yeah, because they'll see your ass up.
They're going to see you in Memphis.
You don't want to go there. I'm just saying, real shit. You don't want to go there, man.
You feel me? But, like, how do you feel about the case? You feel me? Like, did you see most of the evidence?
I didn't. But I got Texas. Because I'm going to keep it real. I'm going to keep it funky. Me, personally, I got a bunch of motherfuckers, friends, cousins, that like, yo. Me, personally, I don't really fuck with them. I'm just saying. You probably do. I really don't, you know what I'm saying? I don't. But I got Texas to get back to his answer. That motherfucker's like, yo, he didn't do this. The bullets came from this way. Or so I'm feeling like, all right, they got a point there. He innocent to me. You know what I mean?
So I feel like this, right? All them ballistic. Listen, once the state come for you or the feds come for you, they come up prepared. Ooh. Like, a lot of murder cases in Baltimore, they don't got ballistics and they don't got forensics and all that. Like they don't do that.
Yeah.
But when you bring forensics into this and ballistics into this, ballistics mean I'm gonna show you if a bullet came from exactly where it should have hit, and forensics gonna show that. He got shot right here. He tried to run out the door. Yep. So the blood dripped like this. Once you do all that and the jury still undecided, bro, that's innocent.
I got you.
You feel me? Like, bro, if your ballistics and forensics don't match up, why I'm still here?
I understand.
Why I'm still sitting in this jail.
I understand.
That's how I feel for real.
I understand.
Personally. You feel me? And other than that, it's just like word of mouth. You can say, you can pull up our text messages. You can pull up our old videos. You can say, I was smiling here and I was happy here. Like, yo, what I'm supposed to be sad all the time?
Yeah.
Oh, I still seen him in his cell last night. He was sneezing. He was smiling. Bro, what the fuck? Supposed to be happy all the time, bro?
Right.
Like, yo, what the fuck? That's how the feds do.
Understand.
So it's like, at this point, like, fuck who wrong, the feds or Melly? Cause like it's like they murdering this man character.
Girl,
so shit. Two murders on the line.
That's how shit.
So now we got Roddy Ricch in jail, one of a early Baltimore legend. He going to be a Baltimore legend. You feel me? Like he just got locked up. I don't know what charges he got locked up for, but they just grabbed him and locked him up. Just like any other person that's about to bubble and leave Baltimore. Like, why you think that is, real? Like, why every time somebody about to bubble out of Baltimore, they got to go to jail first?
It's crazy, man. I like Roddy Ricch, man. I really don't even know what to say about it, for real. Like, it's just like, I just feel like you just got to leave the city, for real, because the city just... You're so corrupt, man.
Now, listen, right? Because this type of stuff didn't happen back in the day. You had niggas like, what, Boss Man? You feel me? A lot of other Baltimore rappers, but like Tim Cheese, they didn't have to go through that. You feel me? Because I don't know if they didn't. If the police know they not going to blow as big as they is. But, like, do you think it's like, all right, now we know these, they going to blow too big for the city, so we want to stop them before they get there type shit?
I mean, it's just crazy because, like, he got all the talent in the world, you know what I mean, to blow, you know what I mean? I'm not sure, but I think Yo just signed a deal with Def Jam. So, Yo should, like I said, like, and I go back to my question, like, Yo should be out of this city, like, cause it's just so bad. And like, shout out to Tim Trees and the guy that was before right. him, like, Chinchy, actually, you know what I mean? Man. I mean, shout even Dudley Street, cause okay. I saw Tim Trees, I saw you get killed by Verb. Shout out to Verb. Shout out to Verb too, cause I saw you get killed in a battle, Tim Trees. Shout out to both of y'all, but you lost that battle. You know what I mean? We just throw that
But we didn't see them like blowing up as big as we seen at that time. Maybe during this time they could have blew up further. But at that time, like, Roddy Ricch was that next, since Scooter, the next nigga.
Yeah, most definitely.
You
most
feel definitely. Me? Since Scooter, that most we definitely. Gonna see this is gonna blow. But you know what? Scooter. And it's hard to get a complete, like, you know, answer onto that. So, I want to go ahead and bring in a special guest, like, a Baltimore native, an Eastside native, you feel me? A fucking... friend of the show.
Okay.
You feel me?
Definitely not a stranger to the show.
Yeah. So he knew exactly what's going on. Type most shit, definitely. You feel me? And get his opinion on this shit. I'm going to bring my man Crack in. That's K-R-A-C-K. C-C-K. I'm for K-R-A-C-C-K. We're going to bring him in and let him get his part in. You feel me? A real Eastside Baltimore type answer. Real. Yes sir, 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 yes s most recent is type shit. You feel me? So, like, how you feel about body bags getting locked up? Like,
man, yeah, like you said earlier and shit. Mm-hmm. You gotta get out the city. Especially if you got some money. Yeah, you gotta leave the city because the city will drag you down. It'll drag you. You come down, that's why tourists and shit like to come down here. They get excited. Motherfuckers do get excited for shit they see on TV and think about, like, wild shit. You feel me? They get excited for that shit. But this city will drag you down. It's fun.
Right.
It can be fun and dangerous.
Chill the fuck out. Y'all tourists better chill the fuck out.
Yeah, that, when you say dangerous, that's like fun to a lot of little young people.
This ain't Ocean City. This ain't Atlantic City.
And let's go for everybody. Like, even you motherfucking Towson motherfucking college dude.
Right.
You walk too far down York Road, your ass is
not a spot for tourists. So whatever happened to you is not gonna be no sympathy for you. But at the same time, as far as Roddy Rats, this rat with, He's supposed to be the next one out. You feel me?
Yeah, fuck, yeah, real fuck shit. Riding. Like I said, Def Jam, man. How big is like, that? Run DMC, man. How big is that?
Locked up behind bars, like Young Moose was. This ain't even spitting a bunch of thug bars.
Shout out to Young Moose, man. Shout out to all the rappers coming up.
Bunch of young thug bars, like thug bars, not young thug bars, but like I ain't spitting these thug bars. This and that, he's been spitting the real.
Yeah, I like Roddy Rich. I can't say that much.
I just don't understand that. And Baltimore B, whatever the fuck y'all call yourself, BPD.
I'm not sure, bro.
The Baltimore Police.
Baltimore Police.
Yeah, the BPD. Oh, okay, I'm not. No, I'm
department.
Not.
Y'all BC, bogus whatever. And shit for that shit. Y'all
BCPD.
But
all y'all.
This not fuck no them. Personal vendetta.
Of course.
Because I've been to y'all was bogus. That's personal. I've been to y'all was bogus. But it's not a personal vendetta.
No, hopefully not. It's not. We don't want that. So if you see my guy on the road, don't try to pull him over because he just laid y'all.
They
bitch
did it in that time.
You serious?
Pull me over. You ain't got shit on him. You better have some shit. You better have some shit.
Leave the guys alone.
All right, man. I got my fellas here. This is my motherfucking game right here. You feel me? So, like, when you see me in the streets, I'm with these niggas. When you see me out the streets or online, I'm with these niggas. You feel me? So 9 times out of 10, you gonna be on that motherfucking 2K.
Ooh,
you feel me?
I ain't gonna lie. I ain't gonna lie.
These guys good. They say they got 2K 24 coming out. Crossplay.
Oh, man.
That's going to be crazy.
Xbox.
That's going to be crazy.
I heard that.
We going to fuck y'all niggas up.
When that happens, it's going to be Xbox against PlayStation. You know how it's going to be.
And
we
going to fuck them up.
That's crazy.
This ain't a PlayStation nigga that can fucking continue
no
with me.
No bullshit.
These my niggas. You feel me? I wanted to ask them. They special opinion on this crossplay. Y'all been fucking niggas up on Xbox for so long. Y'all think y'all ready for these motherfucking PlayStation niggas?
That's gonna be interesting. Wow. I like that. That's gonna be interesting because you got a lot of good motherfuckers on PlayStation that be streaming, and I'll be watching them.
I like that.
You know what I mean? So yeah, that's gonna be good. I can't wait.
Hey, I'm gonna pull a shot when I say this. Personally. Yeah, my man Juan behind the camera, he got this on camera. I'm gonna pull a shot when I say this. You PlayStation 5 niggas stupid. Follow me. Yeah, Vegas 17. Bring the V, nigga. I want to smoke.
Pussy.
Bitch, shit. Gino Gambino 17. Follow, nigga. I want to smoke. Y'all niggas stupid.
Want
the
smoke. Y'all stupid. I want to smoke with you. Real nigga. Shit. I don't know my Xbox shit.
Yeah. 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 My shit cracked.
With a K, nigga.
K, yup.
And we gonna take a ratio who's stupider. Is it the Xbox guys and or the PlayStation 5 guys?
We gonna fuck us with y'all up early.
Of course we is. That's what we do.
Early. Listen. Shit. They said, now listen, we gonna break into this, right?
What's up?
Whatever the nigga name is, Wiyamba,
yeah.
Yeah. They saying he is gonna supposedly start off as a 93 over.
Whoa, rookie. Now that's, I never saw the rookie at 90, nothing.
Like maybe 85. I seen Melo on live.
Whoa.
He was like 85.
Yeah, that's the highest. That's the highest. 80 something.
Bro, 93 rookie, bro.
That's crazy.
What'd that tell you?
I seen LeBron come out of high school stronger than him.
Yes, he did.
And he wasn't a 93. Let's say NBA Live. Mm-hmm. We was watching NBA Live, and LeBron wasn't no motherfucking Carmelo. Carmelo was on the cover of NBA Live.
Yes, he was. Was that 05?
It was a college. Yeah. No. It might have been 05.
Damn, y'all 85. God damn, he in a coke era, y'all. Stop.
That was
please stop, y'all.
That was a good year.
Oh my god.
At the Cubs. Say, you feel me? This nigga Wiyamba, whatever the fuck you call him, is who he say he is. You feel me?
Who he play for?
The Spurs.
Spurs, okay.
Oh, he's not built like how he's supposed to be. He tall.
He gonna end up getting traded.
He tall.
Hell no. Don't say that.
He gonna end up getting traded.
No, cuz.
It could happen. But listen, He tall. He
is the Spurs.
He tall with handles. He tall with handles and a jump shot.
Oh, yeah. That's all you did.
I seen another person like that. And Jen, you hyped him. Zion.
Zion ain't built like this.
No. He was built like that. Give me before you give me to the
Zion. I'm gonna tell you this. Zion listen, built like Chris Webber.
Before you give me the Wiyambe built,
I can't tell you.
Give me the Zion built.
A Chris Webber.
What that mean?
That's good.
No, what that mean? It's good. You mean he can dribble?
That means he's good.
No, what that mean?
This is a freak.
He a Hall of Famer.
Could be. Zion
a Hall of Famer?
I said could be. No, he's not a Hall. Could be. But that right there, that's a freak.
Zion?
That's some name. That's a dinosaur.
Chris Webber was a Hall of Famer out the gate.
Chris Webber is good. That's why I said he could be. And Zion could be.
So why you say he Chris Webber though?
Because his body, you don't see his body like he's Chris Webber.
Who's Chris Webber?
All this dunking and all.
Michigan?
A freak. I'm going to say a guy that wears 265 and can jump. You don't really see that too much.
No, with the Kings. I see Chris Webber.
That's Chris Webber with the Kings? You didn't?
I see Chris Webber.
She's saying with Sacramento. Pull his dunks up.
I'm going to tell you who did.
What about with Sacramento?
265 and can jump.
Charles Barkley did that.
He did too. When you get a chance, look at Chris Webber embarrass Charles Barkley his rookie year. At his rookie year, he embarrassed Charles.
Yeah, he did.
But how many years is that? 8 years?
I'm just saying he embarrassed Charles. He told Charles, sit down.
Zion embarrassed.
He embarrassed himself. He bust out his Nike shoes. What are you talking about? Is that a rhetorical question? What is he talking about, Brassel? What are you talking about?
Big ass fat, I ain't gonna hold you. He definitely did.
Is it crazy? Yeah.
That was fun. Yeah, so fellas, this weekend, I took my daughters on a luxurious trip to Atlantic City.
That's what's up.
King. All expense paid.
My man.
You feel me? Came back. They had everything they needed.
That's good.
Yeah. Clothes good.
That's what's up.
Nice, good time. King. You feel me? Came back to go drop them off to my baby mother house. And then who I run into? Baby mother, baby father. Her other baby father, you feel me? Me and him probably been had tensions for like a year straight. I'm talking about continuously.
He younger than you or older than you?
I don't know. He probably like the same age as me. If not, a year younger.
Okay.
But it was like continuously like a year straight. I ain't gonna lie. I felt like a weight lifting off my shoulder talks on because I was on my shit.
My man.
There's no type of shit I get on.
Right.
I was on that type of shit, you feel me? But, you feel me, talk to him, help me get a load off my chest and type of shit like that. So, basically, I'm unloading my daughter shit out the trunk, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
We got extra shit, you feel me? Here, take this, take that, this yours, here, this yours, mine. He walked over. I don't know if he was going through some shit at the time in the house. Like, you already know. Like, even if a nigga doing some shit, me personally, I ain't gonna trip. Like, it is what it is. Do what you do. I ain't going out that motherfucker. If I'm uptight about some shit, I'm gonna be an uptight the type of way. What? I'm gonna show you this. I'm gonna show you da 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 da. So when he came around, he said, yo, what's up, yo? I said, what's up, yo? He said, why you act funny when you around your homies, but you don't act funny when you by yourself? So at that point, I already know me as a man, bro, I'm a man. That's childish.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a man. From this point on, I'm gonna look you straight in your shit. I ain't gonna altercate shit. I could, but I'm not. I'm not gonna altercate shit to where it's going. I'm gonna look you straight in your shit, and I'm gonna let you know this is what it is, bro. You feel me? Look, fuck is you talking about, bro? That fuck is you talking about is going to take you from here or it's going to take you from here. And he did exactly what I thought he was doing. He was touching my gangster. You feel me? And he, you feel me? Yeah, yo, talk the way to the side, da da da. Yeah, what's up? Like, what you talking about? Yo, I'm just saying, when you hear it be this, it be that, and it don't be like it be different. It be different settings with you, bro. Look, I don't understand what you talking about. He even hit bring my man to it. Yo, why you always bring motherfuckers with you when you come through here? Da 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 da. Bro, when I come through here, bro, when I come through here, trust and believe, none of my niggas is thinking about you, bro. I'm a busy ass nigga. I play the block nigga like you did. You feel me? Nigga hit me with the, I'm from the streets. I do this, I do that, I do this, I do this. Bro, you ain't gonna hit me with that. At the end of the day, you ain't gonna know what the fuck I do. Or what the fuck niggas do around me. You feel me? Like, niggas came with me, yeah, 3 times, picking my kid up. But at the end of the day, niggas was never threatening my shit. That's why I want you getting your head. Niggas, you is not a threat.
I don't even know you, bro.
You is not a beef. I'm not beefing with you, and you's not a threat. That's what baby fathers and boyfriends need to worry about nowadays. It's a difference between being beef and being threat, bro. If you feel like this nigga gonna kill you or this nigga gonna rob you, then that's a beef. That's a threat. If you don't feel like that's what it's going at, then it's not that. Because at the end of the day, I never looked at this man as a beef or a threat. He shouldn't have looked at me as a beef or a threat because I never gave you that type of environment.
It's no beef. It's for the kids.
But just because I say it's not a beef or a threat don't mean it can't be. That's 2 different things. You get to know. Like, just because you think this nigga ain't about that, he might be about that. You feel me? But I ain't gonna put that on you like that. You feel me? So at the end of the day, however you want to carry, you won't carry it like that. So you feel me? I got the really rats of the dude. You feel me? And felt like it wasn't a lot about me. And he felt like he even felt like that when I talked to my baby mother afterwards. She said, "Why you ain't tell me?" He called me my government. Why you ain't tell me such? And he really had a problem.
So would you say it's squash? It's like it's
fuck over. No. I would never say it's squash. You know why? Because I ain't that dumb enough. A nigga, I know niggas in this city is stupid, and there's no shout. There's no threat or nothing towards shorty. And I want this to make the cut. I want this to make the cut. Niggas in this motherfucking city is stupid. You feel me? And they waiting for niggas to say a threat or this and that or this and that. And niggas will switch the shit on you quick. And then they put it like, I be one of them niggas, one of them real niggas behind bars on some stupid shit. No. Listen, at the end of the day, I'm looking like this. Bro, I told him exactly what it is. I never looked at bro as a threat. I never looked at bro as a beef. At the end of the day, whatever happened between that, that's on you, bro. You feel me? And don't be mad at who I got around me or whatever it is. You feel me? Like, after that, it goes what it is. I'm one of them niggas that's loved out here in the city. You feel me? So many niggas love me. Somebody got to hate me.
Good man. Oh. This what you do. Talk your shit done. Podcast. You feel me? So we out here. Big bitch.
Baltimore, nigga.
I hope you don't drop the keys.
I got them in my glove.
Podcast,
you coming back down this way?
That's best. That's best.
Get out the street, man. Big boy. You feel me? Look at my man walk. You feel me? Big boy. RP my man Razor too, you feel me?
RP Razor, man. One more time, say it. Ain't crack. It ain't right till you say it.
That's guys, that's definitely
RP the motherfucking Razor, man.
That's on fire. I ain't even gonna hold
it. Yeah, shout out my man Potts, man.
You already know. Feel me?
RP,
I already know, man.
That's a fact.
Oh my God, look at my God. Damn. Yeah. Hey. Oh, hey.
Oh, I see Razor. We do this shit for Razor, man.
Real shit. You be in or you be out, nigga. You know what it is, man.
Look, nigga. You gotta get those too.
That's on the block. You gotta get those.
You
gotta get those. You gotta get those.
Bring it up all the way to the.
Ooh. Niggas ain't got them. Man,
oh, DVVs.
Niggas ain't got them. They're classic. RP
Bino. DVVs.
RP Bino, man. That's a fact.
It's only take a real nigga to be out here. A real one. That's all it takes. Fam.
Damn.